They write to us, want to tell such a story. From April to October we live in the dacha, so last year I saw the German cockroach on the raspberry shrub, which of course was very surprised. And I touched it with a blade of grass.
It spread its wings and flew away.
Literally a week later I saw the same cockroach on another raspberry shrub, and again at the attempt to touch it, it flew away again. My astonishment had no limits. I went to the internet for information, but there was nothing about it. There is written that so-called croton bugs cannot fly. So the question is, where did they come from? In winter the cottage is not heated, but they were not in the cottage, and there are no them in our apartment as well. It is very strange. Maybe someone has experienced this phenomenon. Indeed, it may seem strange. A German cockroach on the raspberry shrub, not in the house, even more it easily flies away on its own. Croton bugs are known to live exclusively indoors in temperate climate and do not fly. Only when an adult cockroach falls from somewhere, it can spread its wings and flap in the fall to soften the landing. But a German cockroach cannot just take off and fly away.
A couple of weeks later,
the girl was responded in a comment. These are other cockroaches. They live in the wild and are harmless to humans. They are very similar to the common German cockroaches, but if you look closely, you can see that they are gray-brown with spots, and they fly. It seems they are called either Finnish or Lapland. I saw them in the flowers at my dacha too and crushed one once, and another one flew away. So I started looking for information
and read about this harmless cockroach species.
So it is. They are dusky cockroaches. They are not German cockroaches, though resemble them to some extent, and at first sight they can be confused with croton bugs, which suddenly got out of heated houses and decided to stay outdoors without any reason. In fact, dusky cockroaches live only outside human houses. Scientific articles describe several cases of catching them inside houses, but such cases are rare and
atypical for this species. Interestingly, that in these situations,
cockroaches were found but inside houses and on their external structures, on the walls, under the roofs and so on. That is, such guys were just living on someone's cottage property, fumbling near the house, climbing in the walls and occasionally crawling inside the premises. In the same way, say, migratory shield bugs often fly into living flats and scare people there. But they are not considered domestic, synanthropic insects in any way. Exactly, life in the wild makes the dusky cockroaches so remarkable. We used to consider cockroaches as tropical insects, which live either in warm climates without frosty winters or in human dwellings, where there are no frosts either. And for us, in a temperate climate, the cockroach outside of heated rooms looks a bit unusual. In fact, in Europe, not even in the south, but in Central Europe, there are several species of cockroaches from the genus Ectobius of forest cockroaches, one of which is the dusky cockroach. All the species have successfully adapted to the temperate climate with cold winters and live safely in forests, in plantations and parks. And recently they have even actively spread around the world. For example, in the second half of the 20th century they somehow got to the United States, multiplied there, spread, and in the 1980s they were found by scientists there and are now considered quite common insects in several states and some Canadian provinces. Exactly these individuals I found and videotaped in the Ukrainian Carpathians, right in the foothills, in the center of a small tourist town, on shrubs near the administrative building.
All these individuals are males.
They can be easily recognized by their slender, long body and wings that cover the entire abdomen from above. The females are a little shorter and a little thicker, with a wider body. But the most interesting thing is that females and males of this species are active at different times of the day. Males come out on such open leaves and branches after noon and walk about like this until dark. But females crawl out of leaf litter at night. Therefore, by the way, mostly males catch our eyes, and mostly in the evening and at dusk, for which they got their name. I wonder, of course, how these guys find each other to breed if their activity phases do not coincide. But it looks like that somehow they find, because they breed quite successfully and do not intend to become extinct. And it is also interesting that forest cockroaches of the genus Ectobius, to which the dusky cockroaches belong, became extinct in North America about 49 million years ago. At least the youngest fossils of these cockroaches were found in sediments of precisely this age in Colorado. Later, neither fossils remains nor living cockroaches of this genus were found in North America, until 1984, when they were first seen in New Hampshire in the northern United States after such a multi-million year hiatus. Interestingly enough, that this little discovery was made by an entomologist scientist who received cockroaches from tenants of his house. They had caught them on the wall and on the roof and sent him for identification. And that's how, by the way, a little discovery happens. And then reports of encounters with them in neighboring states and Canadian provinces began raining down. And that is in forests and parks, without human houses and with different daily schedules of males and females, these cockroaches breed and spread quite successfully. At the same time, they had to try hard enough to learn how to survive the winter. These adults live only a few months. They emerge in May and die all in September-October. During this time, they mate, and from June to September, the females lay ortecas with eggs under the leaves. These ortecas overwinter, and the following spring, small larvae emerge from them. They molt three times during the summer and autumn, and overwinter in their last instar. The following spring, they molt for the last time and turn into adult cockroaches, which in turn give life to a new generation. This means that if you meet such croton bug-like cockroaches near your house, on raspberry shrubs or on some other vegetation, or even on the wall of your house, so don't worry. These cockroaches are harmless, they will not breed in the house, and they will not shit on your food. They eat rotten leaves, seeds, berries, fruits, green parts of plants, but they do not spoil your garden and vegetable crops, they do not spoil your food, and therefore they are not pests. Such just nice and beautiful cockroaches at your dacha. By the way, they are quite easy to distinguish from the German cockroaches. Dusky cockroaches are not so red, they are more gray, and they do not have longitudinal red and black stripes on the prothorax. But they have dark dots on the wings, which the croton bugs do not have. And yes, they can flap these wings and fly over short distances, which the German cockroaches cannot do. There are several species in the genus Ectobius that are more similar to German cockroaches. For example, the forest cockroach Ectobius sylvestris is almost red, but it also does not have stripes on the prothorax. And the tawny cockroach Ectobius pallidus is just as red as the croton bug, but also without black stripes on the prothorax. If you see them on a shrub or on a tree, then they can be mistaken for the German cockroach at first glance. But the most important difference between forest and German cockroaches, of course, is the place where they can be found. On shrubs, on trees, on leaf litter and decaying wood, croton bugs do not crawl, and if somewhere outdoors on the leaves, especially far from the houses, you see such a cockroach, do not kill it. Smile at it and wish its descendants a safe winter. They will be cold and uncomfortable in winter under the snow and frozen leaves, while some real German cockroaches will warm their asses somewhere in the kitchens, behind radiators and microwave ovens. And yes, if you come across an unfamiliar and interesting insect somewhere, feel free to write about it in a comment or take a video of it and send it to my mail. Exactly that is what the author of the comment that started this video did. Who knows, maybe with your photo and video we will make some new discovery together.